air. Even now, whatever we are using in the form of the diodes, more than that, organic light emitting diodes, OLED, OLED, organic light emitting diodes, recently they are introduced. And one thing, they don't require that backing light. As they don't require the backing light, there are possibilities of higher intensity of light emission as well as with lesser heat emission, with the heat resistance as well as optical clarity, having the such type of filters which are free from optical hazards for the viewers and users and promoters. Likewise, each and every area used to have number of things like metamaterials. Now they have come into metamaterials, more than the materials. Innumerable areas, in each and every area we are going, we are progressing. And no doubt it is the yuga, we used to call in Sanskrit Krita Yuga, Treta Yuga, Dwapara Kali. So this yuga is nano yuga. In spite of the development of various faculties, we used to call in Sanskrit as Visheshana and Visheshya. Nanotechnology is not a different or a distinct technology. It is a Visheshana for all technologies. It is an adjective for all technologies. It is the extension of each and every element to a nanoscale. So nanotechnology is going to be the invisible partner and the predominant comrade in each and every technology that is about to come and that is being emanated now. And some roots of nanotechnology, that is the science of the Paramasukshmanu, as quoted in the scriptures, I want to just quote one or two, and in the Vyakhyana, in the definition, an elucidation given to Anoraniyan. There's a Vedic statement, Anoraniyan. So he is the, that is the atomic dimension of atoms. When this is explained, it is told that the most macroscopic element or expansion is the cosmos. And atom is the basic unit. And here Anoraniyan, it defines the states of God, the subtlety of God. Whatever may be the proportion between an atom as well as a macrocosmic universe, the same proportion in the other side, in the negative integer, is between the atom and the atomic stage of God. So it is quite unimaginable. So this clearly gives an idea about the visibility of atoms, number two, subatomic particles and subsubatomic particles and intra-interatomic particles, their relativity and other things. And Vaisheshika Shastra of Kannada, especially that deals with Paramanuvada. Kannada, he propounded the theory of Vaisheshika, that is a qualified theory of creation, in which he clearly mentions about the atomic structure being the primordial and rudimentary cause for the existence, expansion, dissolution and creation of the world. And here, this Paramanuvada, it deals with a lot of like Tresanu, Mahanu, Sushmanu, it deals with a lot of atomic particles. So all of these things, they are very much understood for just apprehension of the nature of the universe, and the Western science community, which they have understood as well as applied it practically for purposes. There are two types of benefits from the atomic structure understanding of the world. One is the implemental understanding, second is the contemplative understanding. The contemplative understanding of the atomic nature of the universe as practiced by the seers, sages and the spiritual scientists of the yesteryears and millenniums, they have just meditated it as a spiritual process by means of which they were able to see something which we cannot see or we can see only with an instrumental aid, number one. Then the implemented portion of the same thing, which is there in practical distribution, which is being done by the scientists, that has resulted in lot of other developments that we are going to now see, also with their hazards, risk factors and methodologies for rectification and reinstallation of scientific purity and technological infallibility with prosperity and tranquility. So this nanoscience basically that deals with Anuniyantarana Shakti. We used to say in Ashtama Siddhi, the first Siddhi is Anima. Anima is of three types. One, control an atomic structure. Number two, to become an atomic structure, to convert anything into atomic structure. It is known as Anima Trikam, Anurupa Parivartanam,
अनुरूप स्वीकरणम नियंत्रणम तत् अनिमा इत्यभिधीयते द विद्या ऑफ अनिमा इज बिकॉज ऑन दोस टाइम ऑलरेडी पीपल यू नो दैट दे आर कंटिन्यूअसली एंगेज्ड इन वॉर्स साइलेंट वॉर्स स्मार्ट वॉर्स instigated wars, cold wars, different types of wars are there. Apart from the weapons of mass destruction, then great weapons of, divine weapons of mass destruction, if they are also coexisting with these weapons, immediately there will be total extinction of the human species. So lot of things due to the esoteric tradition and lineage, they have been hidden, forgotten or totally being discarded by those people. So the possibility whether it has been implemented by them or not, that is subject to discussion. But possibility of a person attaining an atomic status and possibility of converting something to an atomic level, as well as controlling an atom and manipulating an atomic and molecular structure, is contemplated, that has been pondered, cogitated by them and clearly explained in the treatises. So the possibility is there. And this is known as the nanoscience. And the second thing is, I have already told, taking everything towards an extension of a nanoscale, there is a comparison in shastras, balagra shata bhagasya shata dha kalpitasya cha tayo bhaga savikya sachanantyaya kalpite. It is not an exact arithmetical prediction or something, it is just an approximate idea which elaborates the subtlety of soul, the structure of soul. It says that you take a tip of hair, you divide it into 100 times. You take that 1 by 100 and still further you can divide it into 1 by 100 times. And in that 100 portion may be further classified and segregated, in which a portion will be the width or surface level of a life atom, that is the soul. This is what they explain. And we are confident that we cannot neither take a hair and look at the tip, but we cannot convert and we cannot segregate these things. But still, now we are having that facility, even more than that, that is an approximacy, and even accurate than that, we are having that facility. It is one, for example, if there is one nanometer, it is 1 billionth of a meter, 10 to the power of minus 9. So it is something that what science can define, describe and design. If such thing is very subtler, and subtler than the structures will be something which cannot be understood by science at all. So we used to say something, the optical and objective level coordination, we used to call it in understanding. In understanding any object, the optical and object level coordination, it differs. For example, if you see something below its level, you can understand only the peripherals, the apparent structure of it. If you see something equally to that level of any spirit of understanding with a scientific temper, you can see the structure, function, relativity and other things. You cannot see two things. One is ontology, second thing is teleology. Ontology is the fundamental aboriginal of each and every element, and teleology is the purpose. Lot of things that you design as something useful that may become useless, that may become of lesser use than what you have imagined or dreamt, and that may even give you adverse effect. Whatever that you may think to be good, that may be very evil, resulting in a catastrophic consequence. So anything looked at its own level, that is a coordinate level, that is the scientist's look, and a common man's look is the below level look. And a spiritually understood or less realized personality status, that optical status, is something governed to be as primogenitorial or primeval look, by which he sees the fundamentals, and from that fundamental analysis he used to get the reflection on the creatures and creations. He used to get an idea about the creator, and that is the fundamental, that is ontology. By this ontological mission, he diverts his knowledge towards the things created, so very easily get a fullest idea of that. So that thing has been here understood by the ancient seers and preceptors. By understanding, even more than that, there are two particles apart from the nanoparticle. Now there is a next yuga which is going to come. It is known as a pico. Pico, so lot of other things are yet to come. Even nanoparticles, they are not graspable, they are not traceable, they are not so easily handleable. Means we are yet to receive so many million and millions of time subtler than these materials which are going to move the world. and we can clearly understand about the subtlety of God by saying this. For example, if you